Hi there, welcome to this week's edition of 411-0911. I am Dana and I'm sitting here with Vanessa.
Hello there.
Hey. So today we're going to be talking about children and juvenile type telephone calls into the police department and when you would use 911 versus say non-emergency or the emergency line. So we're just going to go ahead and get right into it, okay? A lot of calls involving children come in often, I take it. One of my questions has always been, if you see, say, a five-year-old in a car alone, or you see a kid walking down the street alone, would that be something that I would call 911 for?
It all depends on the circumstances and the age. For the five-year-old, if they're alone in a car, yes, that's a 911 call. If it's a two-year-old wandering the streets alone with no supervision and diapers per se, it's a 911 call as well.
Okay. Do you have any more examples that you could give us?
Yes. Let's say you're walking past your neighbor's house and you hear a baby or let's say a child screaming and he sounds to be in danger, then definitely you would call 911.
Okay. So if I'm walking my dog and I hear a child like screaming bloody murder, we would call 911 for that. But if it sounds like maybe it's just a tantrum,
then that's not 911 call.
Okay. What if I see a 10-year-old walking down the street all alone?
Once again, it just depends what time of day is it. Let's say it's at 2:30 when school just got out. What if it's 10 p.m. at night? It's just one of those things where you have to think before calling 911. Is it a life or death emergency? Let's say it's past 10 p.m. and is that a normal thing in your neighborhood?
I know in my neighborhood it's not, unless it was like the 4th of July. That would be completely normal, even up until 11 or 12. But yeah, just normally, probably not seeing a 10-year-old,
yes.
I would think, yeah. Okay, what if I see, say, a 15, 16-year-old knocking on someone's door, like a neighbor's door?
No, that's not a life or death emergency.
Okay, and what if they're peering into the windows?
Once again, it's not life or death.
Okay. Is there another option instead of, because I know when I call the non-emergency number, sometimes it takes so long for y'all to answer the phone. Is there another option? Because if someone's peering through a window, maybe they're like casing?
Yes, so you can definitely call our emergency line, and the phone number is 732-0100 with a 916 area code, and you can definitely let us know what's going on at that time.
Okay.
But it's not 911, but okay. It would be the second best phone number to reach us at.
That's good to know. Mm-hmm. If I see these same kids, like 15, 16 years old, breaking into this neighbor's house, I know I'd call the police, but would I call 911?
You would call 911 if that's where somebody lives. If that home is occupied by a resident, definitely call 911. Let's say it's a home that's actually been boarded up, it's vacant, then that's not a life or death situation because there's not somebody there.
Okay, so life and death versus like property.
Yeah.
That's what I'm hearing, and really think about it before you call either 911 or non-emergency, or if you call at all.
Yes.
Okay. So some parents actually call us to try and scare their children, right?
Yes, it happens often, but one of the things I want to mention is that we're not here to scare children at all. Let's think of worst case scenario. If your child was to be lost and were to meet the police at that time, you don't want them to be scared of the police and not approach them when they're in need.
Yeah, I mean, I get why some parents think that that might be a good idea, to come over and pretend to handcuff them or what have you, but especially in today's day and age, we're here to help. That's the bottom line. The police, dispatch, that's our only job, is just to help you guys, the public. So I would hate for a 7-year-old to be scared of us if they really needed them, right?
Definitely. And one of the things I wanted to mention is we do have a cops and clergy division. They're there to assist the public when it comes to help with their children. There's also another resource, which is a 24-hour parental hotline. It's an 800 number. We'll go ahead and attach it after this segment. You can go ahead and reach them at any time as well when you're going through issues with your children.
Okay, I didn't even know about that, so that's great. So yeah, great. We'll post the emergency line, we'll post the emails and this phone number for the 24-hour hotline. That is really good to hear. Also, I think we've pretty much covered it. So if you do have any comments, any questions at all, definitely post them. Someone will get back to you as soon as we can. And I believe next week we're going to be talking about transients and homelessness, specifically with regards to calling us here at 911. Would you even call 911 for a transient? I don't know, would you? We'll find out next week, okay? So we will see you next week. Bye.
Bye.